Please remember to subscribe, click the bell, and enable all notifications. A colossal shout out and thank you to all my awesome members. To join them in becoming a member and support the channel, check out the links in the description down below. Hey guys, and welcome back to 7 Days to Die, Zombie Days. So last episode, let's drop all of this stuff. We got a ton done. We're just waiting for this steel workbench over here to finish. We are making 25 steak and egg. I hope that's not a mistake. Steak and potatoes over there. We do need to quickly do a little bit of upgrades over here at the base, though. We need to make sure that this is reinforced concrete before the horde. And then during the horde, we don't have to worry too much. The stairs, I don't mind. But for example, this over here, if this breaks, we're going to have a hard time with the zombies because they're going to be able to go for the walls then. I think before we upgrade even this, we need to make sure this is reinforced. I need to actually technically make this whole wall steel. Because during the previous horde, the bosses actually did quite a bit of damage. I was surprised at how much damage they could do. Okay, and this I don't mind. This, so technically, we need to make all of this reinforced. So if we have the resources left, I'll definitely do it. By the time we're done with this upgrades over here, I love the fact that it dries so fast. But yeah, by the time we're done with these upgrades, the steel workbench should be done, which means we can finally make ourselves that rat bike. I just hope there isn't another thing that we need. Because so far, everything that we've needed is like locked behind other stuff. So you know how sometimes stuff's level locked? Well, this is item locked. You need this workbench for that, for that, for that. And to make the first workbench, you need a ton of tools to get the next tool, to get the next tool. It's insane. Okay, we have a zombie kill quest. Where's that one? There is a killer rabbit one over here, but we need to do that with a shotgun. Which isn't that difficult, by the way. But there is one that we have to kill a ton of zombie or a ton of animals. And I think we only need like two more animals. So I need to make sure which animals those are. The sooner I can actually complete that, the better. And I can't see it. Okay, let's just skip that for now. Okay, so this generator, I need to make sure that stuff doesn't break like last time. The switch broke and then the turret stopped working. Speaking of turrets, let me just quickly get upstairs quickly. So you do this, you go around, you jump up and over and up and in. Oh, we need to repair this roof as well. So the sooner we get the steel, the better. I want to just make sure that the roof over here is reinforced as well. So that if there is another one of those gyrocopter zombies, the bosses, they can't break through here too easily. Obviously, if they break the hatch, they're going to be able to get in. But for now, I'm more worried about the roof. For some, I don't know why these turrets didn't kill the gyrocopter zombie. Is it not seen as like a threat? I need to actually put this that targets everything except me. Who knows? Perhaps it's just seen as a stranger. Because as far as I know, they didn't try shooting the gyrocopter guy at all during the horde. And that's going to suck later for me because I needed to kill the bosses. What's the point of having turrets up here if they're not going to help me? I need to actually move one or two of these turrets downstairs. You know what? Let me just see this. No ammo. Did they seriously use up all its ammo? Yeah, these two are completely empty. Okay, so I wonder if I shouldn't pick up the corner one over here and the corner one over here. But first, I'm going to have to repair these because they took some damage, and then I'm going to have to put a land claim down. Please tell me this counts as a shotgun. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Don't run too far away. I think it saw me. I do have a purple shotgun that I want to try out. No, it's going to go towards other zombies. I don't want to attract too much attention to myself right now. It ran straight towards that POI and there's a ton of zombies protecting it. For now, I want to just first make sure that we get all this stuff done and then we need to be on our way. Okay, so this is all holding up really well. Let's do this one and this one. I want to make sure that the structural integrity holds. So now we know this won't fall during the horde, or shouldn't fall at least. I just need to put one or two of those shotgun turrets over here and then have a pressure plate or something that I can stand on. Like if I know there's a ton of bosses here at the window, then these turrets that are over here, for example, shoot down at the window. But I need to also put them on a switch so they can stop, because otherwise they're going to kill me. I have had turrets in the past just shoot me for no reason. Like I don't know if I just thought I was a zombie or something, but it definitely shot me. Okay, now I want to see what's better. We do have under ammo three shotguns, right? We have this one over here that is, I should probably put the same ammo in all of them. If it's the same ammo, they'll give us a detailed description of how much damage it's doing. This one is 160 damage. This one is 160 damage. But this one can actually hold, can do 8 shots. This one 3 shots. Now, the rounds per minute are 85, rounds per minute 61. So it's slower, but it has more shots. So obviously, we know which one I should use. This one, we're just going to put some ammo that's not there. Put it away for now. And just use this one. No. Okay, we can repair this one and put away the tool for now. Oh, I was actually almost out of resources anyways. So this is finally done. Please don't tell me we need like a special tool or something for this. I just have this feeling we are going to need it. No. Okay, cool. Let's see. We do have 2 wheels. We do have this. We have an engine. Technically, I should all put all of this stuff where it belongs, with the engines and the batteries. So we do this first. Do this. Do this. Okay, and now we just need the parts. We need the handlebars and the... Wait, what was that? That was the motorcycle. Rack, motor, the chassis and the handlebars. There you go. Now I'm able to make these. I think one of them you actually need dye. The rat red. Although it doesn't show dye yet, so I'm not even going to try. 2 minutes. Not that bad. I wonder if I shouldn't then just try and upgrade as much as possible. If I can get the rat bike to drive around in, we're going to get to where we need to be much faster. So then this motorcycle mini bike out here, I can put away for now. Probably just make sure we have nothing in there. It's a shame you can't get the gas out though. There was a time you could, where you could completely, I think it was Alpha 9 or 10 or 11. But they stopped at some place between that. Where you, when you picked up your mini bike, you needed to actually take it apart and pick it up. Which makes sense. I mean, how are you going to pick up a whole big ass motorcycle or something? Although, how are you going to carry around the parts anyways? Okay, so we need that. We need some gas. We can just as well use a last bit of concrete mix. And then I need to see. Do we have enough stone? We don't have enough sand, right? What if we did this? Made that into... But we need a cement mix. Yeah. We need that. We need a concrete mixer. Okay, let's just go for mixer then. Mix. We should be able to make the mixer. Oh, wow. It shows we can actually make it in the workbench over here. So, I should have made one long ago, but I think the parts we needed was, like, engines over here. Now we have the engines. We do that. What else do we need? 8 springs, 50... 8 springs. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Nope, too many. And then we need 50 of this. Okay, what else do we need? 20 mechanical parts. For those of you wondering, I'm doubling it because of the fact that we will need to make 2. Okay, so I'm just so mad at myself for not making these things earlier, because it seems I could have made it way, way earlier. Now, while those are crafting, we have the rat bike crafting over there. We do need the metal. No, we need the weapon workbench. Weapon workbench, this one over here. Oh, I'm so glad we got 2 of these ratchets. It's a shame we have to use a level 4, but we got it for a reason. Let's use it. Okay, so tools we're also going to need, it seems. One of these and one of these. Am I right? And then we need one weapons. Oh, we need a schematic. Marksman's rifle schematic. I think we should be able to craft one. Yeah, I still don't know how to use the red points. Marksman. I should be able to see. I can craft it over here. This one says we need the notes, but I don't know where to craft that. That's supposed to be on you, but I can't. So that has to be like a special. See, these over here, writs of Pavli variable. Whatever, that's a hammer, that's you. You can make the writs on you. But for some reason, when I'm holding the red notes, I'm going to show you guys this. I just can't. Let's go for the marksman. See, it doesn't allow me to craft it over here. Even this one, there's no W sign. I wonder if I put it over here. Marksman. Although, if I sell all this stuff, guys, we're set. Because we have so many of these notes. There's 112,000 coin right here. The trader's going to be bankrupt by the time he's done with us. So we need some ink to make the actual schematic over here. We need ink. We need 15. Please tell me we have enough parts. I need 15. Oh, no, we don't. We only have 5 rifle parts. Can we make rifle parts? Please, 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 please. No, we can't. That sucks. If you scrap guns, what happens to them? I think you get the parts, right? Let me just see if this is actually worth it. Yes, okay. So I'm going to scrap two of them. I mean, unfortunately, we need them for another quest, but I need these more. I need that schematic. So we're going to grab this. And then we need one paper. Come on. There you go. See, then you can actually make it at this workbench over here. Just need the ink. So marksman. Rifle, there you go. I just need to make one. That's going to be 2 minutes. And with that, we should be able to make ourselves a workbench. So I need to make sure we have everything that we need for the workbench on us. Let's put this away. Tools over here. Did I put stuff back? I need this. And I need the level 3. No, we have the wrench already. Where did I put the ratchet just now? Did I just use a ratchet for some reason? Please don't tell me I just lost a ratchet. It was a level 4 ratchet, so I might have just not realized that I did something with it. Marksman. It's not part of the recipe over here, right? No. A green ratchet. Where the hell did I put the green ratchet? I was only in these boxes over here, so it should be here. I was like, oh, cool, we have the green ratchet for a reason. Please undo this to me. It seems I lost the green ratchet. What the hell? We don't need it for this over here. It's not in my workbench over here. See, we have a crappy quality wrench and claw hammer. I wanted to use that in the past. But now I lost the green ratchet. What the hell? Did I use it for something? I know I used the red one to make this workbench over here. But this... Where is it? Where? I'm actually feeling like spoiling it back. And you guys might notice where I dropped it. But guys, we definitely had a green ratchet just now. And I didn't use it, but it's gone. So I'm going to spawn it back in. Like I did with the vehicle. But as you guys know, the vehicle I actually found later on. So that was me just not paying attention to where I put it. So if I stumble across the other wrench or ratchet now, I'll definitely drop it again. There you go. Oh, thank you. I knew I put it somewhere. I just couldn't remember where. So weapon. And 10 oil. 10 oil. Wait, does that need more than one? Yeah, that just needs one. Remember, that's how many I have on me. I was like, what the hell's going on? Okay, so these three things we need. We need the marksman's rifle schematic, which should be done by now as well. And we can finally make ourselves a weapons workbench. So finally, guys, we'll be able to make our own guns. It's been a long time coming. Now I'm going to be able to craft SMGs and pistols and stuff to complete all those quests as well. Nice. See, so slowly but surely, everything is falling together quite nicely. Guns we'll put over here. Nice. Shotgun turret. Anyways, let's just put this down. Want to quickly refuel it up here. I could have sworn I had a land claim over here on the map. But clearly I don't because it's not. Yeah, I wanted to put like the land claim down here so it covers everything. Did I not have a land claim in the beginning? Or did I just forget to place it? I don't know if I just forgot to place a new one because so far I can't see that one. It might be like in plain view and I'm just missing it. But I could have sworn I've placed... but if I look on the map, there's no land claim over here. Basically, for those of you wondering, the land claim allows you to pick stuff up. For example, I wanted to pick up two turrets up there, but I can't pick them up without the land claim. Land claim, that's going to be... how long? 30 seconds. Eh, not that long. Okay, so we finally have this bike. Just going to test how fast it is. It's not really that much faster. Oh, wait, okay, you pick up speed. Nice. Okay, you are picking up speed, but it is a little bit unwieldy. Like, you have to turn really wide, and look at it. That's how much speed it has. It keeps going. Just completely stop by using spacebar. Now, space... okay, that's more or less the same space. I thought there might be a little bit more space, since it's a new vehicle. Okay, now, this one, I'm going to place... right about here. This should actually cover everything, right? I hope. I hope I'm able to pick up those, well, I can always just destroy it and move it closer. But if I can't pick those up, that was the whole reason of placing that just now. Guys, but finally, we have the metal workstation, we have a rat bike, we have the weapons workbench. Everything that we finally need, we finally have. That's a ton of finallys, but finally. Yeah, that might have just woken up those zombies. I need to be careful of stuff like that. I went way too close to that pure iron. We do have vultures and stuff there. Although, look how fast I'm traveling, so they won't be able to catch me anyways. Okay, these vehicles might have a ton of engines and batteries and stuff. I should grab for them before the zombies start respawning and stuff. Ooh, too fast. Way too fast. Just 1 second, just want to pause quickly. Okay. Just got good news. My brother interrupted me just now, but he said if I order the pizza, he'll pay for us. So he and I are alone at the home together because our parents went for like a holiday resort. Well, they went with family. Although my dad wasn't into it at all, I think they need the rest. So, well, I need also rest. So I hope I can actually go on holiday at the end of the year. Even if I have to pay super a lot for it, I'm definitely going to go on holiday. I'm going to try not to use too much ammo right now, because we only have that much 9mm ammo. What is that? Fire snake, 3000 HP. Does that mean the snake sets you on fire when it bites you? Or does that mean the snake is actually going to... I wonder if this is actually going to work on it. I don't know if he actually vomits at you, or if he bites you and then sets you alight. But being so invisible, it's really hard to tell where he is and hit him. He's definitely a fire guy, I can hear it. Thank you, bye-bye. That's actually the very first fire snake we've gotten, so once again, a new boss. I'm gonna try and see if we can't mostly stealth these guys. Obviously, we're not going to be able to stealth every single zombie in this place. Okay, that's a soldier. Wait, is that a lady lying over there? I wonder if there's a bunker to this place. It does kind of feel huge. Like, it's not just upstairs, but also downstairs something. I need to be careful, though. If there's another one of these fire snakes or whatever snakes there are, I don't know. I think they should bite you to set your light. But those, ooh, hello. Since I've never encountered them before, I have no idea. Duffel bag. I thought I was looting him just now. I was like, oh, wow, nice. Unfortunately not. I'm trying to be quiet as I do this. Because there seems to be a ton of zombies over here. Oh, is that a snake just now? I think that was the anaconda. Something just definitely peeked through over there. The last time that happened to me, I was like, what was that? And then I thought, oh, it must have been my imagination. And when I got closer, it was like the anaconda peeking its head through the wall. He's definitely dead. I don't know, I'm being very quiet right now, but I'm trying to focus. I think inside these rooms, there's going to be bosses and a ton of zombies. So I'm trying to be as quiet as possible now, just to focus on when I hear them. Ooh, my ear's itching on the inside. That's annoying. So as soon as I hear that snake, I'm going to run. I hate snakes. I hate spiders. Ooh, there might be dogs over there. You need to be careful of the vultures on the roof as well. Guys, I'm so lost in focus right now that I might actually be breathing too loud into the mic, so I do apologize for that. It's a habit that even my brother has when he goes... It's a breathing sound at the back of his throat when he opens his mouth. Like, you're so focused, you open your mouth and it just hangs open. So I hope that's not the case and you guys don't hear that disgusting sounds. Okay, please, zombies, do not spawn in late. Okay, so, most of these zombies, I just need to fire from the hip more. It's much, much, much faster clearing this place if I don't have to do that every time. Was this a spider, I think? It seems the zombies and the spiders are at odds. They're at war. But I mean, I'm not going to complain. It helps me out a ton. Also, guys, I used, when mining at the Danger Mining Camp, I used the Mega Crush, and it actually helped really well. What's that? And what I mean by really well is, like, the stamina kept regening for, like, way longer than usual. Way more than I'm used to. Usually it's just for like a few minutes and then it stops, but this time around it kept on regening me. That was kind of awesome. Yeah, we jumped over here, so this should be safe. But I didn't loot anything because I was so afraid of the zombies. Okay, make sure everything over here is empty. Remember guys, all this resources stacks up after a while. And just now you need all of the stuff later for something. Ooh. Ooh. Hello. Oh, that's a lizard guy. Nice. It's awesome when you're actually able to stealth all the people, all the zombies. Although it does look super dark for some reason. It's not just my imagination, right? That just now felt super, super dark. Oh, is there a door between us and them? Because if there is, we need to be careful. Oh. Wait, there is a door. I didn't even realize there was a door over here. That's bad. Oh, okay. You're on fire now? So you should die a little bit easier. And he's down. Go for the head. Go for the head. Go for the head. Thank you. Oh, there's still fire there. You can't see the fire, but they're definitely still getting set alight. Guys, we're gonna get another one of these zombie kill quests. Although, I should have read more advanced kill quests before coming here. Because we're killing so many zombies now, that would have really come in handy. For those of you who don't know what I'm talking about, if you have a green note from quests, you read it, you get a... Well, if you have paper and you have that quest, you can make yourselves a veteran kill quest. So instead of killing 10 zombies, you have to kill 100 zombies. Ooh, purple axe. The payoff's definitely worth it. You get 10,000 XP for completing it. Let me just do this. 10,000 XP for completing it. Two boxes and other resources and stuff as well. I've been paying attention, so I don't know exactly what I'm talking about. Come on, give me some good stuff. What's this? Chirp accessories? Ooh. Then I'll be able to make myself all these vehicles, guys. I just need to actually go mine a bit more or just get more access to resources. I'm a lazy guy, so I don't want to go mine. If I can loot it somewhere, all the more power to me. Although, if we don't have enough resources, I can just make some steel. Or just buy some from a trader later on. Come on, give some good loot. Pipe bombs, nice. That might actually come in handy later. Okay, now, how many more bosses are in this place? That's the question right now. I definitely think I saw a snake earlier. Let me just do that. I definitely think I saw a snake earlier, so I need to be careful not to just run into the anaconda. That thing is super huge, guys. It has a ton of HP, just like the fire snake. Although, technically, it's easier to hit. Because it's so massive, you can hit it easier. The problem is, it's so massive that it moves super, super fast. So if you're not careful, you're going to die from it. What was that? Tomato salad and Nuka base ingredients. Nice. The more stuff like that we can make, the better. I mean, the Mega Crush alone already is a massive, massive help. But if I can make more important things like that, why not? Oh, wow. These things give you a ton of paper. These packs of compressed cardboard. If I hit one, it's about 20 paper right there. Although at the moment, we are set with paper. We don't need any more paper. I know you use it for almost everything, but you only need one paper per. Ooh, it actually works. Nice. Although I have no idea whether this is worth it or not. Because I haven't drank... I don't think I've drunk any of that before, so I need to actually experiment with all the different drinks and foods and stuff. Guys, even after I've been playing this game for so long, I still don't know all the combinations of foods and drinks and what's best for this and that. Like for example, the orange drink, orange juice. That's actually really good for replenishing your water in Darkest Falls. But I almost never made it or drank it. Only like really now and then when I really remembered. Oh, I love being able to pick up chairs and stuff. I need to get out of the habit of Darkest Falls. Since that series is done now, I need to focus on this series. I'm still so focused on you can only do this and this and this. I'm limiting myself because of what I know from Darkest Falls. Okay, so this one we modify. Take this off. Let's test this quickly. This is 94 block damage. 93 block damage. 25 stamina. 27 stamina. So it's not really that worth it, is it? 94, 27. 93, 25. Yeah, it's a little bit more stamina, but let's just use it. Why not? It's the best quality one we have, so it'd be dumb not to use it. We don't have any other stuff that can actually go on there, right? I need to make sure we constantly have enough space on us to just fight whatever we want to fight. So let's also just put the pie bombs on us. And let's go. Okay, now time for upstairs. We still have those rooms outside, which I think also connect to their own, like, dungeon-style stuff. I hate turning a corner like this in the game. Sometimes you turn a corner and you just get simply overrun with, like, a ton of tough zombies. Just want to do that in case someone from upstairs wants to interfere. Okay, as long as I don't see a boss, I'm fine. Am I fine? I'm kind of stressed right now because I definitely heard a zombie's noise coming from the other side. Ah, this is just from the bathrooms. Okay, cool. Unlocked. Remember guys, sometimes these toilets can have weapons in them, so it's definitely worth looting. Whether it be knives or pistols. Now, I wonder if that zombie noise is coming from upstairs or downstairs. It has to be upstairs, right? I blocked off the stairs so they can't interfere from upstairs. And the noise I heard was after making noise downstairs, so I think they definitely woke up. I just want to be careful that there's no, like, bosses all of a sudden just popping up in front of me. I hate jump scares. Especially jump scares that actually mean something. Oh, we need to be careful of not getting stuck over here with a Wandering Horde. That's definitely from upstairs. Nice. Yeah, a Wandering Horde right now would be able to wreck us insanely. What I mean by that is we're stuck inside this room. Since we're stuck inside this room, they can do some real damage to us. I really thought we were able to loot these chairs and stuff, but it seems we're not. It seems that's only in Apocalypse Now mod. Come on, I need the nerdy glasses. If I have the nerdy glasses and I have paper, I can complete yet another quest. I think that's like XP, like bonus XP quest. Yeah, I just want to crouch over here. I want to be careful not to draw too much attention to myself. I think there's going to be a boss or something behind that door, so we need to be careful of how much noise you make. Okay, that was dumb. I can just well do power attacks now, because, I mean, what's the point? Okay, so... No, not that one. Thank you. Oh, there's only those guys. Okay, I thought there might be, like, bosses and stuff back there. And they're gonna break it. Oh, there's a snake. I didn't see the snake just now. Damn. Wait, is this all there is to this place? I mean, I shouldn't complain. This might actually give me some, what do you call it? Springs. And we definitely do need springs. So, oh, 4x4 track accessory. I didn't even realize. Weak fire arrows, that's some easy XP, thank you. Just do this for now. I don't think we're gonna need the boxes. The frames, hopefully not. But you can never be too certain. Come on, I need space. Nurse you back to health. That means we need to go kill some nurses, but I don't want to have too many of those quests on the map right now. Backstrap coffee, why not? I'm getting all the glasses except the one I need. Nerdy glasses right now, guys, is going to help us tremendously. I think that's the book that actually gives you plus 25 experience for killing zombies. Like, it's almost like basically wearing those goggles 24/7, but it's from reading a book made from having the glasses. Okay, I should probably go drop some stuff on a bike because we are way too encumbered for my liking. Need to be careful. All of these zombies are now breaking in. Hello, hello, hello. Guys, I wonder how many of those zombie kill quests I have on me. It's gonna suck if I don't have any of those kill 100 zombie quests on me. I've been killing so many zombies recently, it's insane. Oh, bear. There's a bear, there's a bear, there's a bear. I need to kill the bear for the quest. Wait, what? Is that just a spider? There's no bear. Oh, that sucks. Damn, I really thought there might be a bear. I need to kill the bear for the quest. Okay, so to be careful of all these ferals. I just want to drop stuff on my bike, then I can be out of here. Because I still need to loot some of these rooms, so I have a ton of stuff left to do. Oh, did I just hit my own bike? Okay, so we came from over there, now we have to go over here. I wonder if there's going to be a bunker or something in this. It almost feels like it has the potential. We go upstairs over there. Oh, crap. Yeah, we definitely need to be careful right now. It seems these are the living quarters of some zombies. And some of these rooms seem to be connected because the crawler behind us was at another door just now. And that's just a bike. For a moment, I thought it was something else. Unlocked. Yeah, we need all of this stuff. So I don't mind going through every single room like this. Two springs. There you go. Guys, you only get springs from some of them, and they're super rare, so go for all of them. Oh, hello. Wait, did they just make it through over there? It sounds like they just turned the knob and opened the door. Please, some we have some zombie kill quests, otherwise it's gonna suck. All this wasted XP. Where does this lead to? Bathroom? Okay, okay. Oh, these are just the toilets. The washrooms. Guys, so far so good. I think we're doing really, really well. Please, no bosses. Ooh, that looks like a boss might just be able to fall on our heads. Oh, yeah, I think it might have just been my imagination, hopefully. See, the roof up top looks so super thin. It looks like there might just be a boss there. We need to be careful. And as soon as they break that door, we need to be careful as well. I just had a dinghy. Oh, yes, we got the glasses. I just need 500 paper, but that's at the base. Finally, 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 we have the nerdy glasses. That's truly going to help us a ton. Okay, zombies from downstairs are trying to get up, so let's just stand over here. I have a little bit of a barrier in between us and them. Go, let's go, let's go. Hello? I don't know if they're upstairs, downstairs. Where are all these noises coming from? They might just be on the other side of this door, but it seems like there's zombies downstairs as well. Why can't I kill or destroy that? I want to do this room first before we go upstairs. I want to make sure we clear the place out from bottom to top, or top to bottom. Yeah, no, it's bottom to top. That was right. Okay. Time for a more killing. Oh, no. Okay, this is kind of cool. It's like a small room safe from all the zombies. But did we complete everything now, I wonder? How many more of these are there, I wonder? I really feel like checking my... I really feel like checking my quest right now to see if I have any of those kill 100 zombie quests. Otherwise, guys, this is the biggest waste of my life. There's so many zombies, it's definitely worth having some of those quests equipped. I need to hurry. Time's technically up, but I'm wasting time over here. Now, this time around, there's no crawler. I need to be careful of that. That door leads to over there. Ooh! Okay. Okay. Did not expect that. They came from the back door over there. So, this one leads to the same room I was just in. Oh, that really caught me off guard. I wonder if the previous room also had these book cases, because I didn't see them. Or at least I didn't pay enough attention to see. It's gonna suck if they actually had those and I just didn't pay attention. Because then it's the books that I could have read. The upper I go and the more rooms I go to, the more zombies we all of a sudden have to face. It's just a shame that we have to be so slow at destroying these beds. Because these beds destroy layers, for those who are wondering. Basically, you have to, even though you're strong enough to go through both layers in one shot, you have to do one layer at a time. So the mattress and then the frame. Thank you. That was nice of you guys. I think there's a zombie upstairs. Okay, need to make sure we quickly destroy these beds. Guys, this is just for the springs. We definitely need as many springs as possible, and since we don't get that many, it's so super rare, we have to make sure we grab it every time we see a chance. Ooh, hello, hello. Okay, I'm hitting the block above me for some reason. Okay, untouched, touched, let's go here. These zombies should all be dead. The zombies above us. It's definitely making too much noise to be downstairs. Hello. The previous one definitely didn't have any zombies up here, so this is kind of weird actually seeing a zombie. Now, does this give you springs as well? No. Okay. So I can just do this then. It does give you cloth. Even though it doesn't give springs, it is still worth it or worthwhile. Okay, I think we got everything just now. I hope. It's gonna suck if I miss something just now. Okay, so this one's done. The big room is done and these two houses are done, which means we are done, right? So now I just need to go back to the base and drop all the stuff off. And then next time we have to make sure we don't need any more guns and stuff. We need to complete quests like crazy right now. So I think we should have enough resources and items to... Ooh. Resources and items to actually do a ton of quests. But I first need to get back to the base to make sure of this. I should actually just break all of these. But when you're in a rush, you're in a rush. So next time we are gonna do this POI and keep on moving. But for now, I'm just gonna get back to the base, guys. I need to drop off all the stuff we have on the bike. As you guys can see, this bike is super fast, but you need to make sure you press spacebar to brake in time, like way, way early. Otherwise, you're not gonna be able to brake this thing. So if you guys like this episode, please like and share with your friends. Any comments or tips or feedback? Did I miss anything? What do you guys think about this episode? Anything at all, leave your comments down below. And if you guys are new to this channel, please remember to hit the subscribe button for more of this content. See you guys next time.